In this video, I will be talking about adding lighting fixtures to a small portion of the podium in this small hospital building. I have open a reflected ceiling plan. In this model, there are already some lights in place in the electrical model file that I have open, as well as some lights that are linked in the architectural model. I'll be talking about both of these lights in this video. Lighting fixtures are families, just like the receptacles in the previous video. If I want to add a lighting fixture, I will use the Systems tab on the ribbon on the electrical panel to the far right and choose the Lighting Fixture tool. This will limit the type selector that I have in the properties to just the lighting fixtures. I will choose then the type of lighting fixture that I wish to add. Once I have chosen the family and type that I wish to add to the project, I will go back to the ribbon and choose how I want to add it. The default for face-based families is to place on a vertical face. For my lighting fixtures, in this case a pendant light, I want to place on a face. Now, as I move my cursor back into the project, I can see that I have the "no, you can't do that" symbol when I'm in this area where there is no ceiling involved. However, if I move my cursor over this small room where there is a ceiling, it's actually finding the plane of the ceiling. So place on face is finding the face of the ceiling that's in the linked architectural model. Before I place this with a left click, I'll use the space bar to rotate the fixture, then left click to place the lighting fixture. To get out of the command, I can either escape or choose the modify tool on the ribbon. If, as I am placing light fixtures, I'm looking for a light fixture that doesn't exist or that I cannot find in the type selector here, I can move back up to the ribbon and choose the Load Family tool to look into the standard library. Opening up the Lighting folder and the MEP folder and the Internal folder, I can find that there are many families already created that I can use within the Revit model. Here I'll choose the sconce light. Once I load this into place, the type selector is already pointing to that light fixture. I'll choose the 277 volt to match my lighting system. If the family that you're looking for does not exist either in the project or in your library, you can download new families from Seek. Seek is seek.autodesk.com. I can enter in any value for search, such as lighting, and find a whole list of families to download from manufacturers. If I'm looking for a specific series, I can choose to use a tighter search, or I can use the filter categories on the left. I know that I'm looking for a Philips Caravelle, and so when I enter that, the search narrows this down. As I choose a specific fixture, I am given the opportunity to find the RFA and either download it to 360 or download to a selected folder. I've chosen to download mine to 360. That way I can go to 360 and get all of them at once to download to my project folder. In 360, your families will show up under the documents, and this is just 360.autodesk.com. Once you log in, you will find that your documents are here. To download this, I can either hit the little icon to the left of the image or select the image and pick the download key. Once it downloads, you can either use the same load from library and browse to where you've loaded it, or you can open it in Revit. And once it's open in Revit, you can simply load into project. This is now available to place anywhere within the project. Adding light families to Revit is pretty straightforward. Remember to look for Seek if you need a specific manufacturer's light that you're not finding in your project library or your office standard library.